I've made a copy of ODB 73, and I'm calling this one ODB 74 Invoice Part 2 Forms. Because I went into detail in previous tutorials, there will be less explanation of the details in this invoice example. To create a form, I'm already in Forms. I'm going to use the wizard. And I'm going to create my customers form. I want all the fields. No subform. I'm arranging fields, column labels left. I want to be able to edit, delete, and modify records, so I'm leaving this as is. I'm going to give this the ice blue color with 3D look. And I will keep the customer's name. I want to modify this form right now. I'm going to change the view. Click on my selection arrow. Select everything and move it down a little so I can add in a header with this label field. It looks like it's anchored to the page. Let me right click, change this anchor. Oh, it's anchored as character. I mean, yes, we want this to the page so I can move it around. Going to open up the controls, change the label to be customer form, and I'm going to change that font. We'll give it a bold underline and change the font to Georgia Bold 22. That looks good. Let's take the size back up to 100%. All right. I will save that. And let's move on to our next form. I'm going to use the wizard. I want this to be an invoice form. I'm going to select all the fields. Clicking next. I do want a subform on this one. Clicking the subform based on existing relation to the task table. I want all these fields, but I want them in a specific order. I'm going to put in the description, then the amount owed, then my notes, then my task ID, and then my invoice ID. Clicking next. For my form, I'm going to click this one on the left, the columnar labels on the left, and then the bottom I'm going to leave as the data sheet. I want to be able to add, delete, and modify, so I'm leaving that as is. Changing this to the ice blue 3D. We'll leave this name as invoice and modify the form. The first thing I'm going to do is stretch out our description and also our notes. I'm also going to make our subform, click on that, make this subform a little smaller. Now I want to change the status. So I'm clicking on the checkbox. I'm holding down Control and clicking that. I'm going to stretch this out a little more. And I want to replace with list box. Opening up the controls, I'm going to the data tab. I want the status of value list. And my two values will be 0, shift enter, or 1. Now I'm going to the general tab. And down in these list entries, I'm going to change this to not paid, shift enter, or paid. I also want to make sure that my drop down is turned on. Now I'm coming over to the invoice date, holding down Control and clicking the text box. Actually, I'm going to move these over. So I want to click on the arrow, select the status and the notes, move them to the right. Now I'm going to hold Control and click on the invoice date. I'm adding Shift and the customer ID, and we will stretch these out to the right. Now the invoice date, Control click. I'm going to change my spin button to yes, repeat to yes, and also make sure we get that drop down set to yes. Customer ID, I'm going to hold Control, click on customer ID, right click, replace with list box. Now instead of a value list, we want this to be SQL. From the customer table, want the customer name, customer ID, save, close, and that should be set. For the invoice ID, I gotta open this control back up because I want this to be enabled no. That's an automated number, so we don't want anyone changing that. Last thing I'll do, let me select everything, move it down, and give this form a nice title with our label. Again, it looks like we're anchored as a character. Let's change that anchor to page. Opening up the control, I will change this to say invoice form, changing the font, making this Georgia bold 22. And the font effects to change our underline to bold. I'm going to save this, close, and save the database. Next time, we'll enter in some data.